Hi everyone, welcome to this Getting Started tutorial on the Vue Image Editor component. This component comes with an efficient graphical user interface that allows you to open and edit the image. The Image Editor provides built-in support to zoom, crop image based on selection, add annotation, rotate, and to convert images to different graphical formats like JPEG, PNG, and SVG. In this video, I will show you the steps to create a Vue project using the Vue CLI tool, edit my code using Visual Studio Code, and finally, view the output on a supported browser. First, I open Visual Studio Code. I need to install the Vue CLI tool globally on my machine using the command npm install -g at vue/cli. As I have already installed it in my machine, I am skipping this step here. Then, I create a new Vue project using the command vue create project name. This will create an empty Vue application with no Syncfusion packages. After that, I navigate to the newly created application folder. To start using the Image Editor component, I install the Syncfusion Vue Image Editor package by using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2vue-image-editor --save. This command will install the Vue Image Editor package along with its dependencies. Once the installation is completed, my application is ready to use. The first thing I need to do here is register the trial license key to use Syncfusion Vue components. So, open the main.js file and import the register license method from the Syncfusion EJ2 base package. Using this method, I register the trial license key. From the 2022 Volume 1 release, it is required to register the Vue license key. To see how to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description below. Next, let me import the Syncfusion Vue Image Editor component to use this component in the application. Open the app.vue file and remove the existing code from the file. Then, import the Image Editor component from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Image Editor package. And register this component globally inside the components property to register all child directives globally. To use the component, within the template section, I define a division element and add the Image Editor component. To specify the height and width of the division element, let me define the attributes, the height and width, with custom values. Finally, I am going to add CSS references for the Image Editor. So, let me import the Material Theme CSS reference and add dependency CSS references like buttons, lists, pop-ups, navigations, split buttons, and inputs. Now, everything is configured, so run the application using the command npm run serve. See here, the image editor is rendered with a file browser icon. I click the browser icon and select an image from the local path. You will see the Image Editor component displayed with the selected image and the toolbar enabled with image editing options. Using Zoom In, you can zoom in on the image and move the zoomed region using the pan option. You can zoom out using the zoom out option. To crop the image, I choose the crop option in the toolbar. This pop-up opens with options like custom, circle, square, and various aspect ratios. I select the image region using the circle option and crop that region. Next, let me proceed to edit the image. I click the annotation option, and the pop-up opens with options to add an annotation to the image. I can draw annotations freehand, add text in the image, and include a supported shape. If you want to know more about these annotation options, check out the documentation link in the description. Next, I will show you how to transform an image. Here, I plan to rotate an image to the left, so let me choose to rotate left option and see the image rotated to the left. Similarly, you can also rotate to the right and flip the image both horizontally and vertically. Next, the fine-tune option in the toolbar allows you to have full control over customizing the image look, color balance, and mood. With options like brightness, contrast, hue, saturation, exposure, opacity, and blur, you can easily customize the image to achieve the desired effect. For demonstration purposes, let me adjust the brightness to enhance the image's visual impact by making it brighter or darker and increasing or decreasing the contrast between light and dark areas. Next, let's change the look and feel of an image using the filter option. You have a range of supported filters like default, chrome, cold, warm, grayscale, sepia, and invert. For a quick demonstration, I will apply the cold filter to infuse a cool, bluish tint that enhances the appearance of the image. Apart from these options, you can reset the changes in the editor using the reset option and use the save option to download the image in supported formats. Okay, so far I have shown you the toolbar options and how they work. Next, I will show you how to open an image in the image editor at initial loading. You can open an image using a hosted or online URL link, image data, or Base64. For this demo, I plan to open the image using a hosted link. To do this, I define the created event with an event handler, open image. Add the method section and define this open image method here. Inside this method, I call built-in method named open. To access this method, I need to create an instance, so let me create a reference using the ref attribute. Now, within the open image method, I call the open method by using the image editor instance. To this method, I pass the EJ2 demo image URL link as an argument. Looking here, the image editor is displayed with the image from the online URL link. As I said before, I can save the image using the save option in the toolbar with a default file name and chosen file format. If you want to save the image with a different file name, use the export method. I am planning to save the image in PNG format with the file name Syncfusion using a button click. So, I will use the Syncfusion Vue Buttons component. I install that package using the command npm install at syncfusion/ej2vuebuttons --save. It takes a few seconds to complete the package installation, so let's wait. As you can see, the package is installed. Import the button component from the Syncfusion EJ2 Vue Button package and register this component globally inside the components to register all child directives globally. Then, let me define a division element and set the padding top to align this element. And add the button component with the button content, save. To set the button to primary, I define the isPrimary property to true. Then, I add the onClick event with an event handler save image. And define this method. Within this save image method, I call the export method using the image editor instance and pass the first argument as PNG and the second argument as Syncfusion. See here, when I click the save option, the image is downloaded with the name Syncfusion in PNG format. In this video, I have shown you how to create a Vue project and add a Syncfusion Vue image editor to it. You have also seen how to select a region in the image and crop it. Finally, you saw how to load an image initially and save it with a different file name in a different file format. If you would like to see a working example, you can download one from the GitHub link shared in the description below. You can also check if you qualify for our community license, which gives you a free license key for our entire Vue suite, with the link in the description. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.